Katie. In today's video, we are in my car. I rarely record videos in my car anymore, so figured I'd start doing it a little bit more often again. I hope that's okay with you guys. Also, the air conditioning's on. It is hot. So I hope that you guys don't mind. I hope it's not too loud. I never know. I never know what you guys can hear until I edit, so I hope that it's okay. But anyway, in today's video, I'm going to talk briefly about why I left Charleston. I've gotten that question a couple times, and I know that I've answered it a couple times, but I want to answer it a little bit more thoroughly in this video. And then the rest of the video is going to be my opinions on Charleston, my opinions on my apartment in Charleston, the good, the bad, the ugly, and all that kind of stuff. So if you'd like to know more about why I left my apartment in Charleston and my opinions on the city itself, please keep watching. Oh, and make sure that you're subscribed. Please hit the notification bell, follow me on Instagram, do all the things, please. It'd be fun to have you. All right, so let's get into the video. So like normal, when I'm doing videos like this, I have notes on my phone. Can you see the camera? There you go, cool. Anyway, I have notes on my phone and we're just gonna go through them. I think I have like 15 things that I liked, disliked, opinions about Charleston and stuff. So we're gonna get through the why I left pretty quickly and then we're gonna go into those things. So I know that most of you guys know this, but some of you might not. My name is Katie. Hi, first of all, if you do not know, I already said that, but I'm repeating it. I have lived out of this tiny little car for years, on and off for several years, and then full time for years. And I was driving around America and I was doing all this stuff and I was sleeping in the back seat. And so I was on the road full time for 3 years, you know, staying in apartments every once in a while with my friends, but I never fully moved in. I never had my own place, but I just kind of wanted to know what it would be like again to live full time in an apartment, to have my own place, to buy my own furniture, to have a TV, to like really do apartment life, because I have not done that in years. So I got an apartment in Charleston and my lease was 5 months. I did have to extend it because of everything going on. So I ended up staying there for 7 months. So a lot of you guys have just asked why I was leaving Charleston. I've gotten that question a lot over the last couple weeks. And the like two or three reasons really were because I never planned on moving to Charleston like forever anyway. I never planned on doing that. My whole idea was to live there for a few months as an experiment to see if I liked living in an apartment. And so I was like 99% certain when I moved in that I was going to be leaving after my lease was up. I would either move somewhere else and get an apartment or get back on the road. But with everything going on, I didn't really feel safe and comfortable doing that yet, maybe in a couple months, but not yet. And so I ended up moving to Nashville and I'm staying with my best friend, David. I'm renting out a room in his apartment. So I decided to come here and just kind of do like apartment life kind of for the next couple months. But yeah, essentially I left Charleston because my lease was up and I never really planned on staying there much longer anyway. So that's why I left. And I didn't really love Charleston enough to stay or want to renew my lease again, but I'll get into that later in the video. I know a lot of you guys have asked and I just wanted to explain it a little bit longer in the beginning of this video. So now let's talk about what I liked about Charleston and what I absolutely hated about Charleston and a couple things I was kind of neutral about. So I have notes on my phone. They're in kind of like an order. I think the first half are the things that I really liked, second half are the things that I did not like, and then I have a little bit of an overview, and then this video can be over. Okay, I'm gonna turn down the air a little bit. It's just very, very warm, and you guys know that I overheat very easily. I lowered it a little bit. Is that better? Sorry. So my favorite thing, hands down, about living in Charleston was living near my dad. My dad moved to Charleston about 4 years ago, and where I moved, I ended up being about 20 minutes from him, and so I saw him all the time. We did a bunch of cool stuff, and so that was hands down my favorite part of Charleston, was living near my dad, getting to see my dad. We get along really, really well. If you saw my last video, I guess, or no, the video before my last one. If you saw that one, that's a video with my dad. And then in about, I don't know, a couple days or a week or so, I'm gonna have another video with my dad. He's incredible. He's so awesome. And it was just really cool to be near him. And so that was hands down my favorite part of Charleston. My second favorite part was that I met my new best friend, Kelsey. I mean, my best friend David lives here, but I have a couple best friends. Who doesn't? But my girl best friend, Kelsey, I met her about 2 weeks after I got there in November. We met on Bumble BFF and we just like super hit it off, and now we're best friends. And a lot of people have asked about her recently, like why she hasn't been in my videos, because you know, we weren't really allowed to hang out with people a lot recently. But I was able to see her a couple times before I left, which was really nice. And we already have plans to like hang out in Minneapolis and hang out in like the Northeast. And like, we already have plans to see each other, which is really, really cool. She's incredible. And I met her again on Bumble BFF, which I never used before, but it just worked out. She's the only person I've ever met on Bumble BFF and it worked out really well. So I'm one for one. I mean, not good at the dating on Bumble, but I'm great at the BFF, I guess. And then Kelsey's husband, Tim, is also incredible. He was in one of my videos when we went kayaking a couple months ago. And then they have two dogs, Gloria and Andaz. And I love them so much. I'm gonna put a picture here and show you them. They're the biggest, fluffiest, cutest, sweetest dogs. And I miss them so much. And I love them so much. And that is still tied for second of my favorite part of Charleston, because they're so cute. They're so cute. They're so cute. I miss them so much. Like right now I'm having like I'm sad because I miss those dogs. So the next thing I want to talk about is food. So Charleston is kind of known for being like a foodie town, but as most of you guys know, difficult freaking Katie Carney has a gluten allergy. And so a lot of places, especially in the South, can't really eat, you know, at most places. But Charleston had a couple. I wrote them down just to let you guys know, if you also don't eat gluten as well. Hands down, the best restaurant for gluten-free food was Burton's Grill in Mount Pleasant. I'm not even gonna say it's the best food I've had. It's definitely top three, but I'm saying it's the best one because their menu is insane. They have so many different options. It's a bar and grill, so it's burgers. Their chicken sandwich is divine. Their chicken sandwich, I don't get it with the ham, because why is ham on a chicken sandwich? But it's like chicken avocado. It's so good. I just tried their spinach dip the other day. Incredible. Their burger is really, really good. Not the fork and knife burger. That one's trash, but the regular burgers, and they have a gluten-free bun. Really good. Their french fries are gluten-free. They're fried separately. A plus. And then I recently tried their gluten-free chicken fingers. You have to go there and get chicken fingers and fries, because how often do you find gluten-free chicken fingers? Never. Especially that they have their own fryer. That's like unheard of. So Burton's Grill has a very, very extensive gluten-free menu, and they're super safe about everything. Like the servers really know what they're talking about, and they really like accommodate everyone. So Burton's Grill, I would say, has the best gluten-free menu there. But then also I wrote down Five Loaves Cafe. They also have a really good gluten-free menu. I think their menu, it might be on the same one, but they mark what's gluten-free, I think. But their potato soup is basically just cheesy mashed potatoes. It's so good. And then they have like sandwiches and salads. It's a little cafe, very, very good. And then also on Wednesdays and Saturdays, they have half off bottles of wine, or at least they used to. I don't know if they still do like during everything right now, but I do know that they just recently reopened. So I'm sure that they might have a deal, maybe. But Five Loaves Cafe is really, really good. Local Sushi is really good. That's like a bar. Like it feels like a bar, but they sell sushi and tacos. I've never had the tacos there, but they do have gluten-free options, but they have some gluten-free sushi and it's really, really good. That's kind of the only place that I found in town that I felt safe eating the sushi, because a lot of people might think like, oh, it's just raw fish like and rice, but a lot of sauces like soy sauce and stuff could have gluten. And so a lot of places aren't safe unless they like take precautions. So Local Sushi. And then the best barbecue is Lewis Barbecue. I went there once or twice in videos, so you guys have seen me at Lewis Barbecue, but they're very, very good. I think all their meat is gluten-free, their sauces are gluten-free, and like a couple of their sides are gluten-free, and it's very good. I get the chopped brisket, and I've had the pulled pork. Incredible, divine, gorgeous, beautiful. Love it, miss it already. There definitely were other places that had gluten-free options that either I just didn't love or that I just never tried, because some places could have gluten-free options but still aren't very safe with their options. They might not take cross-contamination really into consideration. Anyway, food was good. Food was not the best, especially because I only really found a couple restaurants I could go to. So while those restaurants were good, overall, gluten-free food in Charleston was eh. You know what I mean? Does that make sense? Oh, I forgot to mention another restaurant that I went to all the time, Dockery's. Dockery's has a very good, their salad, what the heck is, it's called like the lettuce roots or something salad. So good, because their dressing, that buttermilk dressing is so good. And their gluten-free burger is incredible at Dockery's. I forgot to mention that. But anyway, all right, let's get a little quicker. The weather, perfect. Perfect. The weather in Charleston is basically perfect. The summer would have been too hot, but I left. So, but like over the winter, to be somewhere warm in the winter, perfect. The bridges, you guys know how much I love bridges. I've always loved bridges. So to literally have to take a bridge to go to like most bars, or to see my friends, or to see my dad, or to go downtown, or to go to some restaurants, it was like extra fun for me. I love bridges. And speaking of downtown, downtown Charleston is one of the most beautiful downtowns that I've probably ever seen in terms of cities. Gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. Palm trees everywhere. Who does not love palm trees? it's just a beautiful downtown. A lot of like historical buildings, a lot of shops, a lot of restaurants, a lot of bars. You know how in a lot of cities the locals don't hang out downtown? Like Nashville, most locals don't go downtown Nashville very often. But Charleston is the exact opposite. Like a lot of people who live there hang out downtown. It's just, it's a really cool, fun downtown. It's beautiful and very fun, and there's a lot to do. So that's a thing to like about Charleston too. There's a lot to do. I think I wrote, yep, that's literally the next one. There's a lot to do, but I kind of messed up and didn't do much of it. That's what I wrote down. You know, there were quite a bit of times in my stay in Charleston where I was very insanely depressed and I didn't really want to do a lot. There was a lot to do in Charleston. The water obviously is right there, so you can go to the beach whenever you want. I only went a couple times. I don't love the beach. I'm not a huge beach person. It is beautiful there. And I like living near the water and near the beach, but I don't go to the beach very often. I grew up right near the beach. Like I grew up on Long Island. I grew up right near the water. And I, even growing up, like when I was younger and my mom wanted to go, I would go. But as I got older, I just like didn't really want to go anymore. I don't hate the beach, but I just don't, I don't know. I don't love like just hanging out at the beach, I guess. But there's so much to do. So like me and my dad and Kelsey and Tim once while I was living there, they had a little like cruise around the harbor in Daniel Island. And I have footage of that. I'll actually post that like next week or something, because I do have footage from that cruise that I went on when I lived there. So there's that. We went kayaking. Kelsey and I saw dolphins a couple times. Well, she's seen dolphins way more than I have, but I saw them with her a couple times. There's a lot to do there. Like I feel like you can't really get bored in Charleston. And there's also a lot of cities very close. So like I went to Myrtle Beach while I was there. I went to Charlotte. I went to Asheville. Savannah's right there. Like there's a lot of other cities right there as well. There's a lot to do in that area, but then also just in Charleston itself, there's a lot to do. So now we're gonna get into the stuff that I'm like, eh. And then a couple things that I'm like, oh my gosh, I hate. I'm so glad that I don't live there anymore. The eh was bars. That's all my fault though. I love bars. I love going to bars. I love like just being out and like having fun and whatever. Obviously we can't really do that the same right now, but some bars are opening up, but you still gotta be safe. You guys, please be safe. Please be safe. But anyway, there are tons of bars in Charleston. I only ended up going to maybe, I don't even know, like 10 different bars in the whole time I lived there. I feel like the bar that I went to the most was My Father's Mustache, which who named that place? Who named that place? My Father's Mustache. My Father's Mustache. It's not even like a mustache themed place. I don't get it. But I went there a lot because they had darts and I love playing darts, and that's not too far from where I lived. So I went there a lot. And then I went to some bars downtown. I did like uptown. Kelsey and I went once on a Sunday, went like right when I moved there. I think this was maybe like December. We went on a Sunday and they had a band playing a lot of music that like was probably on the radio 20 years ago. Like I think they played some like old school Usher and stuff. It was very fun, like dancey, fun party time. And I think there was only like one bar that I disliked. The rest are just like, yeah, this is cool. Like I'll go here. But I just never found a bar that I loved. I never found the bar that I'm like, yes, I want to go to this bar all the time. Like my favorite bar in Nashville is called Mickey's. It's in East Nashville and they have darts too. If it's my favorite bar, they'll probably have darts. But I just really, really like that bar in Nashville. But I feel like I just never found a bar. And again, my fault, because I only ended up going to like 10 or 12 bars the whole time I lived there. I mean, I just went to a lot of those like multiple times. But definitely my fault for not checking out more. But I just never found a bar that I loved. But I didn't really find bars that I hated either. They were just, a lot of them were just like, oh, cool, a bar. Like, oh, okay, a bar, cool. But also, I think, and I'm going to mention that in a minute, I think a lot of it had to do with the people. But I'll get to that in a second. So the next thing, oh, I already mentioned the beach that I didn't really go very much. It's beautiful, but I only went a couple times because I'm not really a beach person. I never went to the beach. The whole time I lived there, I never once went to the beach just to sit at the beach. I went a couple times to like walk around. I went once with my dad because there's like a bar on the beach in, where were we? Folly Beach, I think. There's like a bar on the beach, so we went there. But I never, the whole time I lived there, went to the beach just to like sit on the beach and hang out. Like that's just not something fun for me. But I mentioned that already. Okay, cool. Next thing. Oh, this is probably my least favorite thing. This is probably my least favorite thing about Charleston, hands down. The dating scene. I know I've mentioned this before in a video from a couple months ago, but wow, Bumble in Charleston was the worst thing that I've probably ever experienced in terms of dating in my life. And this is my experience. This is totally my experience. And so maybe just what I'm looking for, it's not down there, or maybe my expectations were different than their expectations, or it was maybe just the guys on Bumble, maybe guys on other dating apps, or guys that you might meet in real life in person might be better. I don't know. But me and the guys on Bumble in Charleston, no. They were horrible. I only met two guys on Bumble that like I would still talk to right now, that like we just kind of like, we went on, you know, a couple dates each separately, but like within like a couple months, and then we just kind of stayed like friendly. Two out of, I was on there for months and I talked to a lot of people, and it wasn't even like these guys were like horrifically rude or anything. It was just, I personally did not get along with any of them on a dating level. I just really didn't. But we all have preferences in what we look for in a partner, what, you know, qualities we want in someone that we might date. And just honestly, no one in Charleston had those characteristics. And is that me being picky? I don't care. I'm in my 30s and I'm single. I want to be picky. I don't care. But I mean, I'm sure they didn't like me either. So I don't think it was just a one-way street. But it just, there were some about Katie Carney and the dating scene in Charleston that just did not match up. And what's hilarious is, like I said, I met two guys who, like, I would text now and I would say, hey, what's up? Like, we stayed friendly. But the only other guys that I ended up talking to and or meeting that I kind of like thought were cool lived out of town. And they were just there for, you know, a couple days or whatever. And they were just visiting. And Charleston's interesting because a lot of people aren't from Charleston, but even the people who just moved there, they all just kind of acted the same. It was very interesting to me. It was very interesting to me. And again, nothing horrifically rude, or not a lot that was horrifically rude. Some were rude, but most weren't. It was just more that I didn't click with them. That's all it was. I'm not saying that the guys there suck. I'm saying that for me, for dating, it just didn't match up. It just didn't match up. So Charleston in general is, you know, a slower type of town. Nobody's really in a rush there. They're just a little bit more relaxed. They're living like the more of like that beach lifestyle. And while that is so great for so many people, I don't like it. I just don't like it. I like faster paced towns. And because even though there's a lot of stuff to do in Charleston, I still feel like the people and like the vibe, I don't like the word vibe, but you guys know what I mean. Like the whole kind of idea of Charleston is that it's a little bit slower paced and a little bit calmer. And a lot of people love that lifestyle. And so that's a great place to live for them. For me, I don't like that lifestyle. I like a little bit faster, hustle bustle kind of lifestyle and kind of city. And so I like more of like the LA, Nashville kind of places versus a little bit more of like the slow, relaxed places. They're just not for me. And so again, the things that I did not like about Charleston are not like Charleston sucks. It's that I just have preferences and Charleston didn't really match up. You know what I mean? Like, I'm not like crap talking Charleston. It's just that not everyone fits in every city, and I just don't think I fit in Charleston. So it was just a little bit too slow and relaxed for me, which I know some people like literally seek out slow and relaxed and calm and beach towns. And I want more hustle bustle, fast paced. That's just my preference. So the last thing that I hated, and this I hated probably more than I hated the dating scene there, the drivers. Nobody knows how to drive in Charleston. Nobody. And a lot of people, again, a lot of people are not from there. And so part of it is because there are so many people from different parts of the country, and there are obviously different driving styles in different parts of the country, and they just do not mesh up. And nobody's learning. Nobody is seemingly learning how to work together driving. Driving is a team sport. People in Charleston, it's like they're the only person on the road. And I know that that's in other cities as well, but I feel like honestly, in my opinion, driving all over America for years, Charleston's one of the worst. Not in terms of traffic. Traffic there is fake. Like there's no traffic, especially comparing to, you know, LA or Long Island or Atlanta, like other cities like that. Like Charleston traffic, there might be some sometimes, but I think I only saw traffic once, maybe. So I'm not talking about traffic, I'm talking about the drivers. Nobody knows what a blinker is in Charleston. And again, I know there's some other cities that don't know what blinkers are either, but Charleston, nobody knows what a blinker is. So not only do they not use their blinkers and they just cut in front of whoever they want, but also they don't even think to look for other people using their blinkers. So I would turn my blinker on, try to get into a lane, and nobody would go faster or slow down or anything. They would just pretend that they didn't see me. But that's with everyone. They just did not see any other cars. It was like they were the only car on the road. And I know that's common in a lot of places, but in Charleston, wow, it was bad. It was bad. It was bad. The drivers were so bad. There was one day that I drove like 25 minutes away and I almost got hit like twice. And there were no cars on the road at that time. There were like a couple cars on the road. It was not busy. It was not trafficy. It was not congested. Nothing. There were a couple cars on the road. People just do not look. Some guy was merging and didn't see that I was right there. And then I was turning into a lane and some guy tried to merge into a lane that I was turning into. All this stuff, they just do not look out. The drivers are so bad. Not all of them, but a lot of them are really, really bad. And oh my gosh, use your blinker. You guys, we're just trying to be safe here. Use your blinker. Okay, so overall, now that we're 45 minutes into the video, overall, And I even literally wrote, "Dad, don't hate me," because my dad loves Charleston. My dad loves Charleston. But overall, I thought it was fine. I thought it was fine. Like I said, there's a couple things that I really, really liked, and there are a couple things that I hated, and a lot of stuff that's kind of in the middle. But it just, to me, was not a super standout city in terms of what I like, in terms of what I enjoy, in terms of what I prefer. I just didn't love it. Was it beautiful? Yes. Were the people nice? Yeah, they were nice. No, they weren't like standout nice, like I think some people might think in terms of, again, from what I've experienced, but they were fine. They were nice. The people individually were pretty nice. People as a whole were pretty nice. You guys know that when I make, or you might know, you might not, when I make opinions about new cities, I judge, and I don't mean judge in a negative way. I mean judge in a forming an opinion way by four things, but really five, really, really five things. So it's food. The food there was, you know, again, pretty good, pretty okay. I just wish I had more options being gluten-free, but the food that I tried, I would say about half of it was really good and half of it was eh. But again, the really good ones are the restaurants that I mentioned earlier. The drivers and traffic was fine. There was really no traffic, but the drivers were horrific. And then the people individually and the people as a whole. And those were both just like fine. Nothing stand out in a positive or negative way, just kind of neutral. And the fifth one is like the vibe of the city. And I hate the word vibe, but you guys know what I mean, like the feel of the city. And I thought the city felt fine. Very, very easy place to live, a lot of stuff to do, nice people. But again, to me, it didn't feel like super hustle bustle. I didn't meet a lot of like creative people. I just didn't meet a lot of people who I felt like I clicked with. Which again, it's not a bash. I know that some people are gonna watch this who live in Charleston or who love Charleston, and I'm not trying to bash the city. I'm just trying to say that my opinions of it were pretty, like it was nice. It was nice and it was fine. Would I go back to visit? Sure. Would I ever really consider like living there forever? No. You guys know a lot of my favorite cities are Nashville and Minneapolis and LA and Bozeman, which Bozeman's a town city. It's like a really big town. But yeah, Charleston is not, just was not stand out for me. After staying there for 7 months, it just was not really stand out for me. So sorry, Dad, because I know that you love it there, but it was fine. It was very nice being close to my dad and meeting Kelsey. And, you know, a couple of other things I mentioned. But yeah, just like the quick pros, Dad, Kelsey, some of the food, the scenery, really beautiful. The palm trees, the water, downtown, the buildings, just the scenery, beautiful. And that's really all I wrote for like the quick pros. And then the quick cons, dating, the rest of the food was not great. Drivers, use your blinkers. And it's just a little bit too much of like a slow, calm city to me, which I know some people might be laughing like, Katie, like how do you not like a calm city? But you guys know I'm really hyper and I like just a faster paced kind of place. So those are my opinions on Charleston. Again, please don't get offended if you love Charleston. These are just my opinions on my experience there. There's some that I really enjoyed, some that I did not enjoy. I would not really want to live there forever, but I am still glad that I moved there for the time that I moved there, especially that I was able to be really close to my dad and that I was able to meet Kelsey, who I know is gonna be a lifelong friend. So definitely moving there had its perks and I really liked my time living there. I love my apartment. I love the scenery and all that kind of stuff. But just overall as a city of me, you know, either recommending it in terms of if you like similar stuff that I do or in terms of would I ever want to move there or would I really go back if my dad and Kelsey weren't there? Probably not. Maybe if I was driving through, I might stop and, you know, go get some Burton's or go get some Lewis barbecue. But just to me, it was not a super, super standout city. But that's just my opinion. And I wanted to share that with you guys after my time there. And so hope that you guys enjoyed this video. I'm going to be doing the like apartment life versus car life video very, very soon. And I'm going to do a little cruise video soon, another Q&A with my dad. And so I really hope that you guys are subscribed and that you have that notification bell clicked so you get notified of when I post my videos. I post 3 times a week. And I just think that's it. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope that you enjoyed. Hope that you learned a little bit out of it. If you guys have been to Charleston, let me know your comments in the comment section below. And yeah, I guess that's gonna be it. Thanks again for watching, and I hope that you guys have a wonderful day. I love you, Jesus loves you, and I'll talk to you later. Bye.